Okay, so in this video, we're going to take a look at a few examples involving problem solving with time. So for this first question, we have that a movie starts at 8:30 p.m. The film lasts 138 minutes. We need to figure out what time the movie finishes. So all I'm going to do first is convert this 138 minutes into hours and minutes. So we know that there's 60 minutes in an hour. So we know that this 138 minutes is going to be 2 hours, as that would be 120 minutes. And then we're going to be left with another 18 minutes. So 138 minutes is the same as 2 hours and 18 minutes. So now to figure out what time the movie finishes, we're simply just going to add this on. So the movie starts at 8:30 p.m. So all I'm going to do first is add on the hours. So if I add on those 2 hours, that's going to take us to 10:30 p.m. And now all we're going to do is add on the remaining 18 minutes. So we're going to add that 18 onto the 30, which is going to give us 48. So the time would be 10:48 p.m. And that would be our final answer for this one. The movie would finish at 10:48 p.m. This one worked out quite nice because the minutes didn't take it into the next hour. So we're going to look at a few examples involving that now. Okay, for this question, we have that Amy left her home at 9:30 a.m. It took her 22 minutes to walk from her home to the shops. She then spent 15 minutes in the shop. She then walked to her friend's house, which took 35 minutes. At what time did Amy arrive at her friend's house? So for this question, all we're going to do is add on all the individual times as we go along. So we're told right at the beginning that Amy leaves the house at 9:30 a.m. It then takes her 22 minutes to walk from her home to the shops. So we're simply going to add on 22 minutes. So we're still going to have 9 in the hour column. And then if we add on those 22 minutes onto 30, that would give us 52. So we're currently at 9:52. We're then told that Amy spends 15 minutes in the shop. So we now want to add on 15 minutes. Well, we can see here, if we add on those 15 minutes, it's going to take us past 10 o'clock. So all we want to do is see how many minutes it actually takes to get to 10 o'clock. So we're currently at 9:52. We only need to add on another 8 minutes to get to 10 o'clock. So that would get us to 10 o'clock. But we needed to add 15 minutes in total. So we've already added 8 minutes. That means we need to add a further 7 minutes. So if we add 7 minutes onto 10 o'clock, that's going to take us to 10:07 a.m. So then for the final bit, we're told she then walked to her friend's house, which took 35 minutes. So we now need to add on those 35 minutes. So again, we're still going to have 10 in the hour column. So then we need to add that 35 onto the 7. Well, if we do that, that gives us 42. So Amy would arrive at her friend's house at 10:42 a.m. Okay, and for our final question, we've got Bob drives from London to Birmingham. He leaves London at 6:25 a.m. He drives for 1¾ hours before taking a break. He has his break for 30 minutes. He then drives for another 85 minutes until he reaches Birmingham. We need to figure out the time that Bob arrives in Birmingham. So we could do here like we did in the last question, where we figure out each individual time at the point in the journey. But what we could also do is just simply add the times together and then add that onto the starting time. So to make that easier, we're going to find all these times in minutes and then just add them together, because then we can turn that back into hours and minutes. So we're told he drives for 1¾ hours before taking a break. Well, 1 full hour would be 60 minutes. And then 3/4 of an hour is actually 45 minutes. So now all we're going to do is add these two together. So if we do 60, add 45, that's going to give us 105. So for this first bit of the journey, he's driving for 105 minutes. We're then told he has a break for 30 minutes. And then finally, he's going to drive for another 85 minutes until he reaches Birmingham. So all we need to do now is add all these times together. So we're going to take this 105 from the first part of his journey. We're then going to add on the 30 minutes that he takes on his break. And then the last part of his journey, he drove for another 85 minutes until he reached Birmingham. So we're going to add that on as well. So adding these up, we have 5, add 0, add 5, which is 10. So 0 here, carry over our 1. We've then got 3, add 8, which is 11. Add on the 1 we carried over is 12. So 2, carry over our 1. Then finally, we've got 1. Add on the 1 we've just carried over. That's going to give us 2. So in total, Bob's entire journey is going to take 220 minutes. So now what we can do is turn that back into hours and minutes. Well, we know there's 60 minutes in 1 hour, 120 minutes in 2 hours, 180 minutes in 3 hours, and there's 240 minutes in 4 hours. So we can see that 60 will fit into that 220 three full times, so that's 3 hours. So 3 hours, we've just said, is equal to 180 minutes. So if Bob's total journey took 220 minutes, that means that there's a remaining 40 minutes. So 220 minutes is the same as 3 hours and 40 minutes. So now all we're going to do to figure out the time he arrives in Birmingham is take his starting time, which was 6:25, and we're simply going to add on this 3 hours and 40 minutes. So we know he starts at 6:25 a.m. So all we're going to do first is add on the 3 hours. So if I add on 3 hours onto 6:25 a.m, that's going to take us to 9:25 a.m. And then finally, we need to add on the remaining 40 minutes. But we can see here that 40 minutes is actually going to take us past 10 o'clock. So we're going to split it into two parts. First of all, I want to see how many minutes I've got to add on to this 9:25 to get me to 10 o'clock. Well, that would just be 35. I need to add on 35 minutes to get me to 10 o'clock. But because we needed to add 40 minutes in total, that means I'm going to have to add on another 5 minutes. So if I add on 5 minutes to 10 o'clock, that's going to take us to 10:05 a.m. So Bob would leave his house at 6:25 a.m. It would take him 3 hours and 40 minutes to reach Birmingham, which would mean he would arrive at 10:05 a.m. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.